Well, hello there. Let's say we're happy to finally make it to Albuquerque. We've tried to get here for a number of years, and we finally did it. Let me introduce you to everybody. This is Ike Willis. That's Tommy Mars. That's Steve Vai. That's Vinnie Colaiuta. Arthur Barrow. Bob Harris. And Ray White. You ready? Okay. Tell me you love me. Girl, girl, girl. It's so hard now, I'm crying for you. Don't make me lose my pride. I wanna go inside and grab a hold of you. Grab a hold of you. Tell me you love me. Tell me you love me. Like I want you to. Tell me you love me. Tell me you love me. Girl, girl, girl. I wanna feel it. Give me a rub now. Don't make me see that. Don't make me see that. Tell me you love me. Tell me you love me. Tell me you love me, like I want you to. Tell me you love me, tell me you love me. Girl, girl, girl. I love you so hard now, I'm crying for you. I'm burning with fire, I got a hot desire. Cause I gotta make love with you. 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 Thank you. The mystery man came over and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said, look here, brother, who you driving with that cosmic debris? Now who you driving with that cosmic debris? Look here, brother, don't you waste your time. The mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo. But he told me right then when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do with the oil of Aphrodite. And the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, you might not believe this little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too. And I said, hey, look here, brother, who you driving with that cosmic debris? Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? Look here, troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and cram it up your snout.
But I got your crystal ball,
he said, and held it on up to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. I wrapped a newspaper around my head so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumble jumbles then, I told him he was going to sleep. I wrapped his leg and his pocket watch and everything else fell. Shit, I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around, I said, the price of meat has just gone up, and your old lady has just gone down. Look here, brother, who you talking with that cosmic debris? Now, is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho, eh? Don't you know, you can make more money as a pitcher. So don't you waste your time on me. Keep it greasy, so we throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head.
Roll over and grease and dirt, I'm driving through the hometown. And even women, they sure has it tough. Vegan men, well, they just ain't enough. All vegan girls are looking all the time. Good men is something that they can't find. Cause if they find one miraculously, they're trying to be loving as they can be.
Chances are they might not never find one no more. So they keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head.
Roll over and grease it down, I'll drive you through the heart of town. A good loving man, as hard as the mine. A good woman needs to ease her mind.
I know a few that need to ease it behind. All you gotta do is grease it down and everything is fine. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head. Keep it greasy, so we'll throw down his head.
Roll over and grease it, gonna drag you through the heart of town.
A girl don't need no fancy grease to get herself some rump release. Any kind of lube will do. Maybe from another part of you. Lube from the north, lube from the south. Take a little slobber from the side of your mouth. From your mouth, from your mouth, from your mouth, from your mouth. Roll it over. Grease it down. Here come that crazy screaming sound. Ah, 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 ah. Roll it over and grease it down, 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 down. Grease it down, down,
down. Oh, now here comes that screaming salad again.
Walks to Starwood, to the whiskey on the strip. You can hear the crashing plastic scrum from bands that come to be real hip and get a record contract from a talent scout someday. They'll sell their ass, their cocks and balls, and take the check and walk away. If they're lucky, they'll get famous for a week or two, perhaps. They'll buy some ugly clothes to wear and hope the business don't collapse before some cheesy magazine says they're really good. They're a Tinsel Town Rebellion band from downtown Hollywood.
Tinsel Town Rebellion. Tinsel Town Rebellion band. Tinsel Town Rebellion. Tinsel Town Rebellion band.
Stuff and some of it was nice, some of it was musical, but then they took some guy's advice. To get a record deal, he said, they'd have to be more punk, forget their chops and play real dumb, or else they would be sunk. So off they go to SIR to learn some stupid riffs, hey, and practice all their poses between their powder sniffs. Chop a line now. Snort it up now. And when they think they got it, they launch a new career. Who gives a fuck if what they play is somewhat insincere?
Tinsel Town Rebellion. Tinsel Town Rebellion, man.
In Tinsel Town, the people there think substance is a bore. And if your new wave group looks good, they'll hurry on back for more of leather groups and plastic groups and groups that act real queer. The Tinsel Town aficionados come to see and not to hear. But then again, this system is as perfect as a dream. It works for all those record company pricks who come to skim the cream from the cesspools of excitement where Jim Morrison once stood. It's the Tinsel Town Rebellion from downtown gentlemen. This is the part of the show that we call the tune-up meltdown. During this part of the show, the members of the string section get to piddle around with a little tune-up box. They get to turn the knob. They get to turn the peg on the end of the neck. That changes the tension on the string and hopefully puts the son of a bitch back in tune again. So when we start the next song, everything will be alright. But meanwhile, I got this song here. Wait a minute, if I can find it. This is really special. It's brand new. Now listen to this. You can all sing along with this song, okay? It takes absolutely no musical skill. And all you have to do is, when I go like this, pick any note that you want and go, ooh. All right? Try it one time. Perfect. Okay. The name of this song is, There's a Ship Arriving Too Late to Save a Drowning Witch. Ready? There's a ship arriving too late to save a drowning witch. She was swimming along, trying to keep a date with a merchant marine who told her he was really rich. But it doesn't matter no more, she's on the ocean floor. The water's all green down there, and it's not very clean down there. And the pointed hat, well, she's got water in that. And water snakes, and rusty wrecks, is all that she can see. As the light goes dim and she's trying to swim, will she make it? Boy, we sure hope so. Not even a witch ought to be caught on the bottom of America's spew-infested waterways. She could get radiation all over her. She could mutate insanely. And then if she ever got out of the liquid entrapment, she might grow to be 15 feet tall. And scary looking. Even more so than a pre-moistened witch ought to be. And then she might go on the freeway and cause accidents while people looked at her. Cars could crash all over the place from the result of people with Hawaiian shirts on looking up to see her face. With seaweed and urchins emphasizing her cheekbones. Whoa! She could really be ugly and scary looking. Sardines in her eyebrows, lobsters up and down her forehead, all of them terribly large from radiation, and dangerous, and smelling very bad. I don't know, maybe it's better if she stays in the water, and a submarine could save her, and take her home to the Navy. For some kind of ritual sacrifice. Irish center. It was a singles bar on Tuesday night. The moon was dim, the band was tied. They did the bump together. What a splendid sight. Her teeth were white. The drinks were cheap. It was ladies' night. Glad that he met her. She was an office girl.
My name is Betty.
Her favorite group was
Shower Ready.
They discussed the weather. Honey, honey, hey, baby, don't you want a man like me? Honey, honey, hey, baby, don't you want a man like me? Baby, don't you wanna? Baby, don't you wanna? Baby, don't you wanna? She was a lonely sort, just a little too short. Her jokes were dumb. Her favorite sport was hockey in the winter. He was duly impressed and was quick to suggest any sport with a puff had to beep out the best as he jabbed his elbow in her. The candles were trippy. They saw a real hippie who delivered their dinner. The rice was brown, and soon they found that the crowd around that had jammed the room. Bullets seemed to be getting thinner. Honey, honey, hey. Baby, don't you want a man like me? Honey, honey, hey. Baby, don't you want a man like me? Honey, honey, hey. Baby, don't you want a? Baby, don't you want a? Baby, don't you want a? court. She wouldn't kiss him. He tried to ignore it, but it made him angry. He called her a pig, a slut, and a whore, a bitch, and a cunt, and she slammed the door in a petulant frenzy.
A petulant frenzy! This is a petulant frenzy! I'm petulant, and I'm having a frenzy!
On the sofa she weeps. She weeps and she weeps. She weeps and she peeps through the curtain. He just got in his car,
but the battery's dead.
So he has to use the phone, and she gives him some head. And that's the end of the story. Honey, honey, baby, don't you wanna act like me? Honey, honey, baby, don't you wanna act like me? Honey, honey, hey, baby, don't you wanna, baby, don't you wanna, baby, don't you wanna, baby, don't you wanna, man, sometime. Thank you.
Why not come over? You'll meet my mother. You'll meet my sister. You'll like my brother.
Yeah.
they think they're okay, and they got no use for you. All the dead girls of London, why do they act that way? Maybe it's the water, mama, maybe it's the tea, maybe it's the way they was raised. Maybe it's the stuff, what they read in the papers, keeps them looking sort of happy nowadays. All the dead girls of London, why do they act that way? We're the dead girls of London. We think we are fine. We ain't hitting on nothing but the boutique frame of mind. At the disco every night, like a bunch of little robot queens, making little noises full of vague delight, but they're really just so full of beans. All the dead girls of London, why do they act that way? We're the dead girls of London. We thinks we are fine. We ain't hitting on nothing but the bourgeois frame of mind. People with a large amount in an unmarked bank account. Shall we take ourselves seriously? Shall we talk about it all night long? Shall we think we are so evolved? Will we be depressed if we're wrong? Shall we take ourselves seriously? Shall we take ourselves elsewhere? Stupid song, shall we never go out there? Shall we take us where we don't belong? When we notice the sparkle is gone, shall we weep in a box office door?
Go away, I'm no good for you.
Are the tickets all counted? Are the costs all accounted for? At least once more. Shall we take ourselves seriously? Shall we think we are so mature? Shall we be very wrong at the end of the song? Yes, we will the people's eats.
square. You can see it anytime when you get the squints from your downers and your wine.
You're so big, it's so tiny. Every cloud is silver lining. The great escape for all of you.
Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do. Tiny is as tiny do.
Thank you. Kitchen. In the dangerous kitchen, if it ain't one thing, it's another. In the middle of the night when you get home, the bread things are all dry and scratchy. The meat things where the cats ate through the paper. The canned things with the sharp edges. The soft little things on the floor that you step on. They can all be dangerous. Sometimes the milk can hurt you if you put it on your cereal before you smell the plastic container. And the stuff in the strainer has a mind of its own. So be very careful in the dangerous kitchen. When the nighttime has fallen and the roaches are crawling, you can feel like a stranger in the kitchen of danger. The bananas are black, they got flies in the back, and also the chicken in the dish with the foil. When the cream is all clabbered and the salad is frightful, your return in the evening can be less than delightful. You must walk very careful. You must not lean against it. It can get on your clothing and follow you in as you walk to the bedroom. And you take all your clothes off. While you're sleeping, it crawls up. It gets in your bed. It could get on your face then. It could eat your complexion. You could die from the danger of the dangerous kitchen. Who the fuck wants to clean it? It's disgusting and dirty. The sponge on the drainer is stinky and squirty. If you squeeze it when you wipe up, what you get on your hands then could unbalance your glands and make you blind or whatever. In the dangerous kitchen at my house tonight. You didn't try to call me. Why didn't you try?
You didn't try to call me. Why didn't you try? I'm so lonely. No matter who I take home, I keep calling your name.
One die.
Got no heart.
Prisoners grumble and kiss their clothes and scratch their matted hair. A tiny light from a window hole 100 yards away is all they ever get to know about the regular life in the day. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking. Giant fly above the works, and the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture. On the floor, 50 Ugly soldiers manned holding spears by the iron door. Knives and spikes and guns and the likes of every tool of pain. And a sinister midget with a bucket and a mop. A sinister midget with a bucket and a mop. A sinister midget with a bucket and a mop. Where the blood goes down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking, and we've been greenish drunk. In the room where the giant fire above the works, and the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops. In his dungeon of despair, an evil prince eats a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. He eats the snout and the trotter's spurs, where the loins and the groins are soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. He stands and shouts, "Oh man, be cursed." He stands up and he shouts, "Oh man, be cursed." And disagree, well, no wonders. He's the best, of course, of all the worst.
He's the best, of course, of all the worst.
The wrong man done here done it first.
The wrong man done here done it first.
And he stinks so bad, his home's been choking. In the night of the iron sausage, and the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
flies all green and buzzing in the dungeon of despair. Where's the one now? Who are all these people?
Three.
He's locked away down there.
Four.
Are they crazy? Never been explained since at first it was created, but a dungeon just like a sin requires not knocking in everything that's ever been. Look at her.